Eric, you sing the intro music.
I should sing the intro music?
Yeah, sing it quickly.
Mic check.
Those improv classes are really paying off for you, Eric.
Yeah.
Do you know Eric can't do a Swedish accent? Hello! No. You're watching Eric with Chelsea and Tony live. And this episode is brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace is the easiest way to create a beautiful website, blog, or online store for you, your ideas, and your portfolio. Squarespace features an elegant interface, beautiful templates, and incredible 24/7 customer support. Try Squarespace at squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code portfolio and you can get 10% off. You can try a 14-day free trial, no credit card needed. And if you like it, you can buy it for as low as $9 a month. Hey, that's less than a couple of coffees from Starbucks. Would you rather have a portfolio that could build your career or two coffees that you just pee out in a couple hours? Okay?
I want coffee.
The Squarespace people are going to be so pleased with that endorsement.
That's going to be their new tagline. Instead of, they're like, say, build it beautiful. They'll be like, pee out coffee. Okay. Today, our guest is Eric Alvinmad, and he's a pretty good photographer. And a great friend.
Yeah.
So today we'll be looking at dog.
Better friend than photographer, if you know what we're saying.
But in his defense, he's an excellent friend. He's a great dog photographer. He's done a lot of professional dog photography. You can see the covers of his magazines here. And you showed us how to take some dog pictures the other day.
Yeah. Yeah, that was great fun.
And now today you'll be helping people take better dog pictures.
Yeah, hopefully. Yeah.
Or
not.
Or killing their dreams.
So we're looking at your dog pictures today. If you want to send in your dog pictures for a review live on the show, go to sdp.io/submit. When you're prompted, enter the password puppy.
Yes.
While you're putting those pictures in, we can talk to Eric about which website did you use to make these novelty covers?
Faux photographer.
They're actually they real look so magazine good. Covers, don't they?
Oh, okay. But the letters are weird. Like, what's up with the weird words?
Right. That's Swedish.
Eric is Swedish.
Mm, yeah. Some of those
you know
are,
the Vikings who are
words we can't
you.
Even show on YouTube, I think.
Yeah.
I know how to say, like, so fast. Hogfart.
Yes. Hogfart.
Oh, that means high speed.
High speed. High speed.
Yeah. High speed. We're learning speed Swedish control. One funny word at a time.
Yeah.
Hogfart.
Speed control is fart control.
Sorry, Eric, to bring down your career in one show.
No. This is how people think I am anyway.
Okay.
So,
okay.
So you
no
shot
surprises.
You shot all these covers. That's
yeah,
really
those
remarkable.
Those are all my covers. Yeah. Yeah.
Dogs and hats. That's really controversial. I'm surprised you'd go there. Did those dogs?
Yeah. Sometimes you have to do whatever necessary to get the shot.
Yeah. Maybe you're covering a receding hairline or something.
Yeah, well, this was my first cover, actually, so I would just about do anything to get the cover.
No, these are all
yeah, they're great.
Really great pictures, and it's such an honor to have a cover on a big magazine like that.
Yeah.
Oh, this picture is just stellar. What a fantastic action moment. And I really like that the owner is in there, too, kind of interacting with the dog. It tells this whole story.
Yeah it could be a stock photo. It's excellent.
Yeah.
That's actually a Helium Terrier. We don't have those in the States.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Wow. So this is a dog.
It's two with dogs.
it's a hunting dog that hunts other dogs?
Yeah. It's weird.
Yeah, that is weird. Not something a lot of dog lovers are into, but...
No, I like it.
Yeah.
Beautiful. The dog's expression, too.
Yeah, it's very proud when he's coming back with that. Yeah.
Oh, goodness.
He tried to catch the fox, too, but... He didn't.
He's running from the dog catching dog.
Yeah, I almost adopted this guy.
Oh.
What? Yeah. Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. It was just, well, they had this whole litter of dogs, like 7 or 8 puppies, mm-hmm. and all the others were running after their mom, mm-hmm. except for this one. He was just tagging along me all the time.
Oh.
So it's like, yeah.
What kind of dog is it?
Nobody ever remembers. Yeah.
Oh, perfect exposure on it. The nose is nice and dark, but the fur isn't blown out at all.
Yeah.
Oh, I love this.
This is absolutely adorable. What a fantastic
expression.
He looks
so insane. It's so cute.
Yeah. There were actually two in this session, and they were both completely crazy. You could see the expression on his face. I've never seen a dog that wild.
What before. Is he running towards?
Towards me, towards the owner behind me.
And she has a stake?
No. Well, that's a good point, actually. You have to find something to motivate the dogs. But these guys were so easy, so, you know, they just ran.
What anyway. Do you shoot with? What gear do you use?
Usually the lens is 70 to 200 because it gives some flexibility mm-hmm. in terms of focal length. And the 2.8 will give you that shallow depth of field. So it's just a great lens. And up until now, I've been using my D800.
Yeah.
But now, since I've been here, I've been trying the D500, and I'm just blown away. It's yeah. just so good.
You ordered one.
Funny anecdote, because I have, we own the D500, and we're borrowing the 200 to 500. Yeah. So Erica came, and I thought, you should try this out. Yeah. And like that same day, you tried it out and you immediately went and you ordered it. And you're like, can this get here before I leave? Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Overnight delivery, whatever it takes, I have to have this gear right away.
Exactly.
So your quick review of the D500 and 200 to 500 Nikon.
It's just fantastic.
It's cute.
You do amazing. Have goosebumps.
I do have goosebumps. Look at that. Can you zoom in on that? No.
Oh, wow. Well, how much?
No, but it's so fast. I mean, it shoots 10 frames per second.
Yeah.
And the autofocusing is so quick.
It's amazing.
I mean, it's like there's no delay. You just point there, pew, point there, and it hits everything.
It really is remarkable. And you're coming from the D800, which has kind of an older autofocus system and 4 frames a second,
well,
I think,
you're
right?
You're calling my D800 old?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's getting up there.
She's beautiful.
Well, she's done great work.
That fast.
but look at all the great action shots that you got with it. Like, you still got the job done.
And this is with the D800, so I'm just. I can't wait to try it.
But you'll be using it as a second camera because you shoot a lot of weddings as well.
Sure.
And on top of these dog shots, you do other photography. So it'll be good.
Yeah.
This dog is so sweet and proud looking.
Yeah.
And you really captured its personality.
Yeah. It is really regal and just overall a perfect picture. Like,
I usually don't do studio shots, but I wanted to include it because sometimes I do.
Oh.
Yeah. That's the classic running towards. He just picked that up on the way.
Yeah. What is it with dogs and sticks? Like,
yeah, I don't know.
That's your dog.
That's my dog. Yeah, it's Shiro.
Yeah, what a beautiful and thoughtful picture.
Yeah.
And this was on the cover of this the was, magazine.
Yeah, the latest cover was this. Yeah. So, I like this a lot. It's not easy to get both the ball and the dog like that. So.
Yeah, Wow, nicely done.
I love this one.
Yeah.
What is he going after? Is that a treat?
That's just a treat. Yeah. Mm. So.
It looks like a seasonal allergy ad for dogs, doesn't it? He's like, oh, I'm free.
This is what they would show when they were talking to you about the various side effects.
Yeah.
Like, may cause terminal illnesses.
Yeah, some mental
But it's
issues.
A great picture.
Yeah.
I love this one, too.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a bit moody.
Yeah, it is really solemn.
Yeah. And that's from the same session, actually.
Oh. Yeah.
And this is just, trying to keep it simple.
I love that background blur. I just can't believe that's with the 70 to 200.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh. And actually I used the fill flash on this. I don't usually do that. From the back. So I just wanted to lift it up, and it's such a dark face as well.
It looks great.
Yeah. That's a great tip. And I can see a little bit of the light in the eyes from the flash.
And it just adds to the action.
Mm-hmm.
That's something I learned from you as we were shooting my dog Sandy. We brought her to the beach, and you specifically wanted her like kicking up the sand.
Right.
And you're right, it helps to convey that movement.
Yeah, we even put her in the water for a while just to get some water droplets flying off her.
Yeah.
So anything like that, sand, water, snow, is good.
Do you prefer the backlighting or the front lighting?
Backlighting.
Backlighting is better.
Yeah. I will say we made a video about this that we'll have out on our channel soon with Erky. Mm-hmm. He was generous enough to give us his time and take pictures of our dogs at the beach, or our dog Sandy.
Yeah.
So you'll have tips for them, and then you can teach them how to take photos.
Sure. Yeah.
And look at this beautiful dog.
Shot. Yeah, I do shoot a lot of agility contests, but this might be my best one actually.
It's a fantastic shot.
Yeah.
The colors are great too.
Yeah.
Look at these two.
Yeah.
I like the levitating.
They look like they come straight from hell. Especially with that light going on. But I got a little overboard with the processing. Possibly I took a Jake Olson class, and then I just went nuts with it.
I would So.
Yeah. You're actually joking about.
No, I'm not. No.
Oh, you really did?
I bought one of those, you know, tutorials that he sells. He had a big sale. So.
You helped pay for that Porsche.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, but I only did that one time and now I'm just can't be bothered with it.
Yeah. Beautiful pose here.
That
with
is beautiful.
Flowers.
I love the environment.
Yeah. This is, if you go back to the to that one, because between landing and the yellow field behind him, there's a road. Oh. But by lowering my angle, you can't see the road. So it gives you a completely different perspective here. So yeah, with the road, it wouldn't be as good.
Yeah. And this is something we talk about all the time, but you have this prominent line here. And you got down low enough so that it passes behind the right. dog's head. And that just adds so much depth. Mm-hmm. If that line were up here, above the head, it would just be a totally different picture. It wouldn't have that same depth.
Yeah.
And I recognize this beautiful young lady.
This beautiful little monster. That's
she's,
our dog,
she's
Sandy.
A firecracker. I love her.
Yeah, she's very sweet.
It's my dog, Sandy. She's 12 now. So not everybody knows. But she's like a really pretty senior dog. Yeah. But still a total spaz. Just having a really good time at the beach.
Yeah, she caught me off guard. I never thought she could do that at 12. You know?
Oh, more Sandy. Mm. Your pictures have this like 3D look to them. Don't you feel like she's about to pop off the screen at you?
Yeah.
I'm not sure why that is.
Up the field and you're down low also. It, so,
Yeah.
I love just all this the sand that's getting kicked up here.
Yeah, that's why I included that, just to show this is a perfect boom, right?
Yeah. Yeah, that adds so much action to it.
Yeah.
Oh, two pretty
Who's
animals.
That in the back?
That's me trying to actually get out of the background. So.
Yeah. So you did hear me. You did hear me when I told you to get out of the way.
You were like, get out of the background. I'm like, right. I'm the slowest runner.
Okay, let's take a look at some pictures before we.
That's where my skills
Tony,
at.
The
exactly what that way.
We are using last week's password.
Oh right,
but what I swapped it? Out the title, so I think we'll be okay.
Okay, I forgot to update the password. So what is last week's password?
Ohos.
What is it?
Ohos.
OJOS is today's password. I'm sorry, guys. I forgot to update the password. I could change it real quick.
Yeah. No, it's
now so... we're too far in.
Yeah, we're too
the
far.
Password
in.
OJOS.
Yeah, that Sorry, makes guys. No sense.
Should just take the password.
Well, dogs have eyes.
They do.
Spanish dogs.
Some of them do.
Ow.
Okay, you people entertain us while I import this.
Erky, tell us about this really nice rum that you brought for us. So Erky's actually actually before you say that, can I tell them something? Erky met us through our group. He bought our book, and our book comes with a readers group. And you reached out to us, and we became fast friends.
Yeah.
People might not realize this from the show, but you're actually a very nice person.
Yeah, well, you're just saying that because we're live.
But so we started chatting, and then we met up with you in Stockholm.
Yeah.
And then we met up a few years ago in Amsterdam. Mm-hmm. And now you're staying with us in our home, and we're so happy to have you.
It's amazing to be here.
Thank you. Yeah. And you were kind enough
to I can say that off camera, too.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's all try the rum.
So this is Ron Socapa rum, 23-year-old. Oh. Yeah.
23? That's the same age as me.
Yeah, me too. And Sandy.
Salute. Mm-hmm. That is the smoothest rum I've ever had.
It
fantastic.
Really is.
You know how to do it.
Yeah.
Very good.
This cutie, look at those big eyes. Mm. Dogs always look so silly.
I think he looks ashamed of his hat.
Yeah, I don't think he likes wearing that.
I hate it.
And I can appreciate that somehow.
Oh my gosh, that is the most beautiful dog.
And Chelsea loves pit bulls.
Yeah.
I will kiss it.
Though I totally wish we had the ear weren't kind of
Siobhan,
like...
Siobhan, look.
Yeah, looks a bit... unbalanced.
Oh,
oh my goodness. Oh. I got to give that one a pick. It's a beautiful picture, right? The dog. What is it called when you have different colored eyes? There's a fancy
tetrachrome.
Word. Tetrachrome.
Is it? No.
Justin knows.
Because people can have that too.
Hand, no.
No, Justin knows everything. I just kind of assumed.
Yeah. I can't remember.
Anyway, so oh, cool. I want to have a dog like that just because of the eyes.
Yeah, beautiful picture.
Yeah, right.
Why did Chelsea leave?
I'm not sure.
Oh, all right.
It's your wife. Don't ask.
Doesn't mean I understand her.
Yeah, I know. I hear you.
This picture feels a little bit low contrast to me.
Low contrast?
Don't you think?
Wait, let me check.
I like the snow to be white, so I'm just going to raise those white points and get a little bit of white in there. And just brighten it up a little bit. Snow can be tough.
Yeah. Maybe that lamppost should go, like clone out.
Yeah. Because
my eyes.
Yeah, this isn't going to work well, but.
Yeah.
Okay, look. That could have been worse. You didn't do terrible Photoshop.
Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
This is from us.
Oh.
Thank you.
This is actually from Kyle Wolf.
Oh, okay.
Justin, could you just hit a camera or something?
Yeah,
hit your camera for me.
We're looking at the dog.
I hate to put you to work, but Chelsea's giving Justin birthday presents.
Thank Justin's birthday you.
And it was
Sunday,
off camera.
Right?
Yeah, it sure is.
Happy birthday, Justin.
Happy birthday, Justin.
And you should probably
open.
Yeah.
I'll come back to you for a second.
We love Justin.
Yeah, we do.
Sorry to run away and interrupt, but this is
very we were just wondering where you went off.
Well, you know, I can still hear you when I leave the room.
We forgot all about her. Do you notice?
Yeah, I just moved on. I already have a Tinder profile.
But I love having you as a guest on my show.
Didn't take long.
Am I the most difficult guest you've ever had?
Yes.
You did call me a diva.
By far.
I know.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. I like that, what you did with the whites there.
Yeah, snow is tough. It'll throw off the camera's metering system. It shouldn't be 18 millimeter 1/320 ISO 200. This is definitely a time when you could have shot at ISO 100, and you know 1/160 would have been fine. But great composition. You got low in the ground. I'm confident you got wet and cold.
Yeah. Then you know you're doing it right.
Yeah. And you have these elements kind of behind the dog's head, so you're not looking down at the dog. You're at eye level with the dog.
You know what this dog? He beautiful reminds me of
he's a proud dog.
Tyrion Lannister from Game of Thrones.
Why?
Because he looks so proud, but he's small.
Right.
Yeah. He looks like
Tyrion.
He looks like he has like a big attitude, big spirit.
Exposure, up contrast.
Yeah, yeah. Let's turn that snow white.
Yeah. He's been having some fun in the snow. I recognize that nose.
That or
when they just dive in.
Yeah, could be.
Is he from Amsterdam?
He could be. Look at that. He's from LA.
That actually looks like one of your shots.
He looks like he's walking on two legs.
You didn't submit to the show, did you, Ricky?
No. But I like this.
It's great.
It is totally cute. He's got his tongue out. I'm giving that one a pick, too. I'm giving out lots of picks today.
Yeah, it's fine. Oh, my gosh. Stop it.
Go to sdp.io/top tip, because here we discuss white and black points, and we literally the fourth picture ever.
Yeah,
exactly. Gotta brighten that up a little bit.
There are two things that needs to go. Do you see it?
The little red plant.
Yeah, the red plant and that little twig
stick
or whatever.
Maybe the twig is why he's freaking out.
Maybe it's his twig.
Mm-hmm.
His favorite twig.
Do you ever see a dog do that? They pick up a little like leaf or something and lose their minds. That's so cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, not everybody's a huge fan of cloning stuff out, but Erky and I think Chelsea too, are all kind of like perfectionists about distractions. And
yeah. Well, it's not just perfectionism, I think, because the eye go there, no matter if you're a perfectionist or not. You're taking the attention away from the dog.
You could physically feel it when you looked at this picture. You looked at the dog, but then you looked at these two other things.
That was the first thing that I noticed.
But there's no payoff when you go to look at a stick that's random. Like, it's not part of the story.
Unless you're a dog, because dogs like sticks.
Can we talk about the expression in the pose, though? So cute.
Yeah, I love this pose. And he's looking straight into... He's looking at you like, you want to play?
Yeah.
Are we going to play now?
Yes, it's so cute.
Yeah, I love that. He's ready.
It's very engaging. It's a great shot.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, a good action shot, but again, a lot of distractions in here.
You know what? They could do this with the settings. I think they need it's F4, but...
Well, 2000 is good, but ISO 400, so the shutter speed just a little bit.
What shutter speed do you use for these sorts of running towards the camera shots?
As high as possible. I mean, it depends on the light.
Yeah,
basically, I increase the shutter until I see that the ISO is getting too high.
Mm.
So, but for action shots, the faster the better.
Yeah.
Right. So in this case, about 2/1000 of a second is pretty fast for a dog, especially. So I would probably drop it 12. That would bring the ISO down.
Yeah. Yeah, but and the light here is almost kind of high noon. The light could be more interesting. Yeah, it could be in a different environment without these sorts of distractions. But the action on the dog is great.
Yeah, maybe. But he's going down. He could go a little bit further down and just get rid of the distractions, mm-hmm. find You're a better location.
Yeah, so. Closer to eye level. He's still kind of looking down at the dog.
Yeah, yeah. But it's a good effort.
Oh,
this dog's adorable. Though I felt my eye go immediately to this purple shoe.
Yeah, but you know what? I think it almost tells a story.
Yeah.
They're in a public place. I see all of the feet, and he's kind of just patiently by his owner's side.
No, I agree with you. In this case.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, what did he steal? This is hilarious.
Oh, that's a pick.
Oh, that was Chelsea's pancake.
That was Chelsea's pancake.
No.
Yeah, we're giving that one a pick.
That's crazy.
This is nitpicky, but he was ready. Somebody
threw the pancake, and he took the shot as he was catching it. Because I don't think this dog is that crazy.
But the sad cat.
Can I have some pancake?
Can I have some pancake?
Yeah. You're a cat. You don't eat pancakes. Stupid. You can have a fish or a scallop.
Oh, I love the little cat's face.
Corner. I'm sorry.
Oh, this up here?
I have to stop doing that, right?
No.
No?
You do you.
I do you.
This is your show.
I do you. I do me.
Guess.
No, but seriously, I mean, it's such a great shot. And then that pink corner.
Okay, we can. Yeah.
But it's a great angle. I love that.
What?
I don't know why that didn't clone up. But
yeah.
So, and Denver shows me the before and after on the crop. And then there's something up with the white balance. Don't you think?
Well, he warmed it up, yellow. I think. This is your photo. Look, or the dog's name is Tony, maybe.
Tony's
photo. Tony photo.
Oh, a little Tony
maybe
dog?
Somebody named their dog after me.
I think there's different light sources. That's why.
Just go back to the other one. Just a trick. That might be fun. Uh-huh. When a dog is sleeping like this, focus on the paws.
I was thinking that, yeah.
But just leave the background blur enough so you can still see the dog's features.
The eyes are closed anyway, so you're not getting that eye contact.
Yeah.
So you do kind of want to look at these cute feet. I agree with you.
Just
the Viking.
The Viking.
Yeah, I agree with the Viking. Yeah.
The Vikings always did shoot their dogs like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, hundreds of years ago.
Let's talk about this.
BentleyMotors.com made this. I think it's what did we decide? It was like 53 gigapixel panorama. And I'll open it up here. Let's go full screen. So it's cool. You can, it's like a picture of the Golden Gate Bridge, but it's actually a picture of a Bentley.
But you can only zoom into this one spot. You can't zoom in all over the picture.
There are lots of little tricks that they did here. So this is kind of slow. I'm scrolling as fast as I can. So you can get in from that wide shot to an image of the actual stitching.
That's what they're wondering.
And, right. So this really fascinated me and I really researched it because the press release that Bentley released is deceiving in some ways. First, they say it uses NASA technology.
NASA technique, I thought they said.
Yeah, technique developed by NASA, which makes it sound like space age.
But used on the Mars rover. I think the technology they were talking about is just image stitching.
It seems like all they've done is, there's a lot of photoshopping in the image. It's not a true panorama.
But Erky, what do you see? If they stitch together a bunch of photos, do you see anything wrong? Because Tony and I noticed there's some things that are not possible. What do you see? Does anyone else in the audience what would happen if you stitched together all these photos? Would they say 70 photos?
They said 700. 700 photos, adding up to like 53 gigapixels. I don't remember the exact numbers.
Yeah.
But that would require like, I think I decided 150 megapixel camera.
Yeah.
Because panoramas have overlap, but they used a DA10.
They did.
Which is a 36 megapixel camera.
But
they, it's clearly a composite.
Yeah, okay, so
it's
if you took
a proper panorama.
Erky, if you took 700 pictures and stitched them together, you wouldn't have a consistent lens flare.
Well, they could have done that in post.
Yeah, but what we're saying is it's a composite. It's not exactly the same as, you know, like a panorama, because this is the other thing. The pictures go into one spot. They won't let you zoom into that detail anywhere else on the photo because it's not.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's only that high gigapixel rating in the middle of the picture. Hmm. The rest of it wouldn't be. They said at some points they used a 1200 millimeter Nikon lens, which presumably would get to that center point, though I didn't try to do the math on it.
Is that car actually on the bridge?
I don't believe that. I mean, maybe they ran a car over the bridge. But I think much of this car is a comp. You can see that even as you get close, it's perfectly sharp.
How would they get the panning at that distance?
Right.
That's another thing.
And as you pan, you'll notice, like, look here, the water is panned, but there's a sailboat here.
Yeah.
Which
is in focus.
Is not panned, and the background here is. It's not a panorama, even though they kind of did it that way.
No, it's more, it's just a composite, I think.
And I'll also say there's no way, regardless of the lens sharpness or the camera detail, that the car would look this clear through that much atmosphere, especially on a cloudy day.
Oh, in San Francisco?
What?
Right.
Hello? I mean,
you would zoom all the way over there and take that picture that sharp?
Yeah, how would you ever
it's impossible.
How would you ever get through a windshield? And look at the highlights on the car as well. It's a sunny day.
Yeah.
You can see there's a blue sky. Mm-hmm. And they're shooting that far away through a windshield and getting this in focus. I think this whole car is a studio shot.
It's busted.
Busted, right? I think the car is stitched together.
Maybe the photographer will
shots.
Contact us and tell us how he did it.
Yeah, I actually looked at the photographer's portfolio, and he does a lot of automotive shots.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of them have this kind of fake motion blur and like radial blur on the wheels. And that's just how you do kind of automotive. He had a good automotive portfolio, and this shot indeed is good. It's also a cool concept. It's just the way Bentley kind of positioned it in their press release, and then every news outlet repeated that it's this like 50 gigapixel panorama when it's not.
No.
Yeah. It's not what they said it was.
It's still a really
cool idea.
Yes.
It's really cool idea.
If they had just been kind of honest about it.
Yeah. I just wish I wanted to see the boat. Why
you can't
why
zoom
did
in.
They put the boat there if you can't zoom in on it? That's just rude.
Because I don't think the picture has that level of detail anymore.
I know, but so get rid of the boat.
And also the boat is right between the high tension wires.
Exactly. Right.
I also say by the time and 700 partly cloudy day like this, the sun will move in and out of clouds, which means every picture you take is going to be a slightly different light and exposure. And it's kind of impossible to do that. So they definitely took like a wide angle picture.
Unless you have 700 cameras.
Yes, that would be brilliant, but they did not. They had AD-88.
So it's not impossible. I'm just
okay.
Erky, stop.
You regret this now, right?
Go back to Sweden. No,
yeah.
Speaking of Sweden, Hasselblad, which is a Swedish company, announced the X1D, a medium format mirrorless camera, and I recorded a whole overview video about it that I have yet to publish because I didn't want to publish it at the same time as the live show.
Oh.
Anyway, it's 50 megapixels. It uses a Sony sensor. It has a 0.8x crop factor, so it's not exactly much. It's not much bigger than a full frame sensor, but it's a little bit bigger than a 35 millimeter sensor. It has, how many lenses do you think are available for it?
Three.
Two. There are two lenses. They're both prime lenses, not even like a versatile zoom. So you better be happy shooting at like an equivalent 35 millimeters or 70 millimeters, because that's what you can shoot at.
Jeez, Tony, you're such a Canon fanboy. Don't you know you can make it into a pinhole camera?
But it is really cool, and you can adapt other Hasselblad lenses. So if you
how much is it?
Oh, it's pocket change. It's $9,000, or $14,000 with the lenses.
Oh, okay. Reason.
But you can shoot at 35 millimeters or 70 millimeters, Chelsea. It's so versatile.
Think about it.
Think about it. Oh. When you put it in those arms.
Yeah.
What is this, Tony?
Well, we released, like, included the D5, Nikon D5, their $6,500 camera, in like four or five of our comparisons already. And one of our big complaints has been that it can record 4K video for 3 minutes And everybody's been saying Nikon's going to release a firmware update. And I reached out to Nikon and I said, are you going to really release a firmware update? And they're like, we can't comment. And I'm like, but if you tell me, then I can say you might be releasing an update. If you won't comment on it, then I just have to say, don't buy the camera if you want video. And they're like, can't comment on it. Anyway, they released the firmware update. So now you can record 30 minutes. And I had to go back and kind of like update all my reviews and say the 3-minute limitation is gone. But so that's good. It's good.
That's good.
I wish they
had... It's better. It's
Tony,
not good.
Why do you
it's
think
better.
They would tell you stuff?
I wish they would, you know, or just tell care everybody, not you? Just me, but anyway.
I don't care.
That's cool.
Hey, this episode is brought to you by Squarespace. We've talked about it. It's great. You can get Squarespace for 14 days for free. No credit card needed. If you like it, buy it. If you don't. It's great.
I pulled up two portfolios. Which one strikes you guys?
Wait, before we do this, can we just talk to Siobhan? I miss her.
Okay.
And I feel like maybe she has some questions from the people in the world.
What do you have, Siobhan?
From the world.
We didn't really introduce Siobhan. Siobhan out in Philadelphia. She's screening her comments.
I can't hear her.
Siobhan's muted.
Oh, I got her. Sorry, Siobhan, you're on.
Are you okay here?
I was having technical difficulties, so it's okay that you didn't show me earlier because I was frantically trying to get my headphones to work. But I have questions for you.
Okay.
Not good ones, but I'll ask you anyway.
That's a critique of all you people out there.
Here's one that's not photography related. Hey, could you ask what they all did on their 21st birthday? Mine is in a week, and I want to get drunk and watch TC Live. What do you recommend?
21st?
Drinking age in the United States. What did you do, Tony?
I'm trying to remember. Of course I had my first drink of alcohol.
Didn't you just work?
Drinking, I'm sure I was just working. And I mean, they weren't really strict about carding in Texas.
You also probably had gray hair.
I did have some gray hairs and I had been working in an office. I remember I used to go out for happy hour because I just worked in an office environment from the time I was a co-worker for happy hour because I was hanging out carded or anything. So I had just been accustomed to hanging out at bars and stuff. So it wasn't, I don't remember it being noteworthy at all for me. It wasn't like a milestone. And Erky, 18 is kind of the 21 in Sweden, right?
Yeah.
So what'd you do in your 18th birthday?
Well, I don't remember.
So it was that fun. Good.
No, actually, I had a birthday together with a friend. He was just like 3 days after me. So we got a rental truck from a gas station, and we pulled it up to the because in Sweden you can only buy alcohol in one place. It's controlled by the government.
And apparently you can also so we took this gas truck. Stations.
Yeah, no, we can't
just skim over that.
We took the truck.
Sweden's crazy.
We went to the store, and we had gathered money from all of our friends. And everyone, and we just got in there with a big pile of cash, and we just said, "Just mix something for us." The truck is in the back, and then we went off. Had a great party.
Is that because you didn't know how to buy booze, or just like I don't know, buy alcohol,
yeah,
please?
Buy alcohol. I want alcohol.
I'll have
alcohol.
8 alcohol. Here's
my ID, like that. So yeah, something like that.
Cool.
But after that, I have no memory.
What about you, Chelsea? Did you go to a flapper party?
I probably just stayed home. Grandma style.
You're wild and crazy. I bet, Justin, do you have a good turning 21 story? You must have, you are a wild child. What did you do?
Yeah, Justin was the craziest one.
No, not really. Because I had like a fake ID for like 2 years. Yeah. With the guy's name, it was really close to mine too, and he looked like me. It was pretty awesome. But the bartender had a shot glass necklace, and I convinced him to give me his shot glass necklace, so that was cool.
And do you still have it?
No.
Well, anyway, I think that you should have a nice, responsible night in with your grandmother.
Yes.
Siobhan, do you have a good turning 21 story? One of us must have a good story. I mean, your story was good, no. Erky.
I mean, it was okay. Goodish. It was too Swedish. Too Swedish for me.
Yeah. No, I'd also been drinking for way too long at that point. I think I went to a bar that I'd been going to underage for a year, and
You showed them your real ID for the first time.
Yeah, they were like, "Your name's not Jessica." Yeah.
All right, we're all about influence.
Yeah.
Well, let's take a minute and look at Rodolfo Lozano's. Sorry, I don't know. Rodolfo Lozano's portfolio. It's actually pretty amazing. He is clearly a professional photographer because I see
multiple people
to his photos. Like, these seem to be like distinctly fashion photos. These are very distinctly like casting headshots, right? So there are a couple of shots of the same people, but I actually feel okay about it here because I think he's saying, you're one person, but I'm going to make you look different ways. Here's a moody shot. Here's a more upbeat shot. And I think for an actor, that could be really meaningful. Like, okay, he took the picture of the same gal, but with different hairstyles and made it look different. What are your thoughts, people? I don't know what Everlong is, huh? Everlong?
No. I have a hard time with that staggered format. I always say it. A lot of people use it. And my problem with it is you can have a nice picture like this, and because of the orientation of the photo, it shows up very small. And then you have a photo like this, and everything in it is small, so it's not very impactful. If you had a full website, the scrolling one, then you could see every picture at a reasonable size. But I just don't know that the template is the right one.
I feel like these could be thinned out a little. Like this one, it doesn't strike me. Maybe with some editing, like it's a little yellow and there's this kind of unbalance to it.
Let's click on it.
Dad is definitely eating a sock-covered foot.
Yeah. Dad's doing that.
Unbalanced too.
So yeah, maybe pare these shots down a little bit.
Yeah.
The greatest view.
Great shots.
Yeah, good shots. Yeah. Ooh, I like these.
Oh, this is almost exactly like that Bentley. It's the same place.
That's
right?
Weird.
Is the Bentley there?
It's still there.
Zoom, enhance.
It's broken down on the bridge.
Also, I think it was spot color, but we'll let it slide this time.
Oh, two spot color. He doesn't watch the show.
No. It's not his fault.
It is. That was tilted. It literally is.
Reflection.
Am I viewing this from the wrong side? Because it looks like they're all
tilted.
Whoa,
look at that one.
No, maybe it's not.
A couple of pictures have struck me as off-level, so that's something to consider.
Oh, that's
great.
That's beautiful.
That's
nice.
Wow.
Oh, was that a bird in the in the bottom one? This one. Is that
Oh, yeah.
Eagle.
That's a good focal point. Hmm. Okay. Make yourself.
Sure. Oh, Tony, it's you.
Actually, up there is you.
That's me.
Yeah.
I was literally looking for myself. You fooled me. You think this? Oh, because he has a trombone. I used to play trombone, which it turns out is not a cool instrument. I'm just finding this out now. I wish somebody had told me when I was 11 and picking it up for the first time, like, this is not going to help you at any point in your life. Maybe get a saxophone or a trumpet or something. Mm. Sorry, other trombone players, to betray you, but I have to tip people off before they get too far down the whole trombone path. That's a cool angle.
Yeah.
So you're saying like in 20 years there will be no trombone players?
No, now that I've leaked the secret, trombone players will be gone. Dying breed.
Yeah. They're dinosaurs.
The downtown, so street photography, and then I bet this is about him. There's Rodolfo. That's a very cool
I like that
picture of yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, so Erky, what advice would you give him about?
Let's hear.
Advice on this portfolio.
Yes.
I don't see any prices.
Oh, so you're a fan of the pricing page too?
Yeah, definitely. I think people are lazy. Mm-hmm. They want to know, go into detail and say exactly how much it's going to cost you. You can give some samples.
Yeah.
Like, roughly, what are you after? It's going to cost you something like this. But contact me and we'll talk about it, right? Because I think this requires people to contact him to know how much it's going to be.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people, they don't want to do that. You know, they're lazy. They just skip to the next photographer on the Google search.
I totally agree. And I think a lot of people they could be embarrassed that they'll call and the person will say it's $12,000, and then they'll be like, "Oh, I'm too poor for
that's
this."
Too or, much. Yeah,
yeah, because yeah. I think people are a little intimidated by that.
Yeah,
Chelsea is not necessarily a fan. She doesn't think it's a requirement.
I think it depends. Yeah. I think that if your prices are very high, then you don't necessarily have to list them. Or if you're doing commercial photography, or if your clients are other professionals, like if you're getting hired for magazines or something like that, then you wouldn't list your prices.
Yeah, that's true.
Because if they have to ask, they can't afford you.
Yeah. But most people are not that type of photographer.
Yeah.
I mean, most of us just struggle to get a session here and there and make some money. And if you're at that level, then pricing helps, I think.
Yeah, I agree. Mm. I agree. But I do think that there are times when you might not want to.
Yeah.
Okay, so we provided some other...
Second time I agree with you, right?
You've agreed with me at least three times in my life. In my life.
Oh, in your life, yeah. But two in the last hour.
Wow.
We also suggested paring back some of the pictures and perhaps changing the layout. Here's what Rodolfo has to say about Squarespace. Squarespace is great. It allows me to display my work in a very professional way, and it's so easy to use. I appreciate your feedback on my portfolio. Thanks. Thank you, Rodolfo, for sending it in. That's brace. If you want your own Squarespace portfolio, your pictures can look as awesome as Rodolfo, assuming you have pictures as awesome as Rodolfo's. But it's a lot easier than WordPress, right, Erky? How many WordPress plugins do you have?
Yeah. No, Squarespace sites look good.
Yeah,
I have to admit.
And WordPress is not free, no matter what people say. You end up paying much for your slew of plugins. WordPress.
Yeah.
If you want Squarespace, it's way easier than WordPress. Go to squarespace.com/Tony to sign up. Get a 14-day free trial. No credit card required. And then after your trial, you can use the coupon code portfolio once you actually have to pay. And that will save you 10% and let them know that you heard about it from us. Thanks so much. We can, I'll re-import some pictures, see what else people have sent in.
I'm going to talk about cutting to Siobhan soon.
Yeah.
Because she's going to have to look and see if she likes the comments. I like to give her a good head start. So
you're not just warning her that we're going to go to her. You're warning her that we're going to warn her.
I like to do that, like a nice long lead in. And then she doesn't feel stressed. Siobhan.
Yeah.
Do you have any questions?
Yeah. Every time I insult them, they step up their game.
Oh, good.
She's like one of those waitresses at a diner that insults you, but you like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah. Egging works on our audience. I have some questions for Erky.
What?
How do you get a sharp shot of a dog running at full speed that is still bright and detailed? Are there flash techniques available?
I'm sorry. The sound is a bit low. Did you ask how to get the sharp shot of a running dog?
Bright and detailed.
Bright and detailed.
Yes.
Wow. Well, of course, you need to plan your shoot to have the best possible light for the occasion. If you can't have that, then you can use artificial light in forms of flashes. But like 95% of the time, I just use natural light. It's much easier, especially with dogs that are running all over the place.
Yeah, they're changing their distance to the flash, which can kind of screw everything up. And
exactly.
You definitely would have to be using high-speed sync because you're at like 1/2000th of a second.
Right, yeah. So the artificial light. I try to plan the shoot for the right time and the right location. So I scout around different locations to find good spots for when I have a dog shoot. I know we can go there. And when to go there.
Use an all focus points or a single focus point?
Single focus all the time.
Just that you try to keep it on the eye?
No, not necessarily, because the shot is normally taken at some distance and the depth of field, even though it's shallow, it's not paper thin.
Yeah, because you're further away.
Exactly, you're further away. So you have maybe, I don't know, 30, 40 centimeters that you don't know what that is, but about
that. We know. I know right? centimeters.
Yeah. So, and that's enough to get the whole like head in focus. What I tend to do if we're talking about the running dogs is to lower the, you use single point, but then you don't keep it in the center. I tend to lower it a little bit because like if you have the viewfinder here, if you lower it, then you get more of the surrounding. Get more of the dog and less of the ground.
Yeah.
Unless you have something very interesting to show on the ground, which is almost never.
Yeah.
then just pull that center point down maybe one or two steps. But to get it bright, because it is a rock, it's an action shot. Shutter and just fill the buff.
And you also go out during the golden.
Stockholm is pick up at 3 a.m.
Less 10 that's like 3 hours.
Yeah, let's have
anything else for us.
Oh no.
Okay, I'll check it out.
That's a bummer.
Well, really, it's been a long day / night.
Yeah, what do you do? Because you're not a
winter wedding that I might do.
I was checking to make sure our stream was still on. Sorry.
Saying, you're just watching our show while we're on our show.
It's my favorite show.
Yeah. I love that show. Oh, let me see. Okay. No, but other than that, you just have to shoot when you have daylight. I mean, it's not dark 24 hours a day, at least not in Stockholm where I live. If you go further north, it is. But then I have some dog shoots in wintertime as well, and you can get some really cool pictures of dogs running in the snow. It's just instead of shooting like now, I would probably plan shoot around 8 p.m. because the sun sets like around 10.
Yeah.
If it sets at all. But in wintertime, that would be maybe at 1 p.m. because the sun starts setting at 3 or 3:30.
Oh, wow. Right?
So it's just a matter of timing. Providing you have daylight at some point during the day, you're good. Yeah.
I also have to say, just as an inspirational tidbit, you also work a full-time job.
Yeah.
In a very high level position. Mm-hmm. So you work full time at a very demanding job.
Yeah.
Then you do your photography business on the weekend.
And evenings.
For a lot of people that I know, they could do that as a full time job for the amount of work that you get. Mm-hmm. Because you get a lot of weddings and you get a lot of big gigs, magazine covers. And he's got it all going on.
Yeah.
You should ask him a lot of questions. He's got secrets.
Yeah. Just stop sleeping.
He actually has so much energy. I don't think he sleeps.
No. Half an hour is enough, I think.
Well, let's quickly go through some pictures. This, I think, is a really cute composition, but we miss focus on the eye.
What? Really?
Yeah.
Don't you think?
Focus is just in front of the
okay.
eye. Yeah. So for me, single autofocus point, of course. Mm-hmm. But I'll also just use back button focus and let off that back button focus and lean in and out. Because the dog's still, so you can hold the shutter button down and just lean in and out a little bit.
He likes to do this.
And then you'll pick the sharpest one.
I'm just practicing.
Mine evaporated.
I've done that.
Okay.
Treat sampler.
Are there no settings anymore? The metadata?
It depends how they export it.
I'd say the depth of field is too deep because the background is distractingly in focus for me.
Right. Yeah, you kind of have to, I mean, I don't know what sort of lens they would need to blur the background at that short distance, but plan the location because like a product shot for bark shot. And an open field might be better. But the dog itself is really cute. And
he's like, these are my cookies.
Well, better location, but I like the concept.
Yeah, me too.
Like treat sampler, and then it's got those little bags.
Open
I don't know. If this is a commercially thing, then maybe I would like to see what
the
flavors.
Bags. Yes.
Yeah, what flavors are they?
And also,
which one does he like?
It seems to be the premise is the dog doesn't really care about eating the treats.
Like the favorite one is like the second one from the right. Then that ring is empty because he already ate that. That's his favorite.
Yeah. I think that this
dog is well behaved.
He has a dog at a job at a grocery store handing these out to other dogs. He's like, one please.
The dog on a trampoline.
That's cute.
Yeah, it's cute. Colorful.
Yeah.
That leaf should have been maybe removed, but.
Shy.
Oh no,
very
he doesn't want to
shy.
Be there. Yeah.
What is there, like a netting or something in front of it? What's this?
I'm not sure.
Well, terribly cute. I'm distracted by nothing important, but.
But I mean, technically, it's good. It's sharp. But he looks so sad. I don't think he wants to be there. He's forced to be
there.
He's
like, oh, man.
Yeah, it is something about his expression. He's not thrilled, but you can tell from his posture, his ears are back, and yeah.
So, and that's tricky with dogs.
Sometimes you can make a funny sound and then they put their, they perk their ears up, kind of like, what is that? So if you have a funny whistle or something different or a squeaky toy or something, you can get a better expression out of them. And some dogs are just camera shy.
Yeah.
I'm totally screwing up your picture. I just wanted to see you. Because I'm pretty sure we could see it in the eye.
Okay. One day we're very strange.
Yeah. Just, I'm glad you're impressed
actually looks
that.
Very cool.
Yeah, like touched by an angel dog.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. We'll allow it because it's cute, but check the edges of the frame you clipped off.
Are they dogs? Or they just look like dogs?
They're canids. They're definitely
how do they
dogs.
Sound? What does the fox say?
Have you ever heard of
yeah, they don't, the they fox? Yeah, they don't bark. They don't bark. They have this sound from straight from hell.
Hell.
Yeah.
It's a demon's call.
Yeah.
Have you ever heard it, Justin?
No. Just coyotes and stuff.
That awful sound I just made, that wasn't an exaggeration. That's actually what it sounds like.
It's much worse than that.
Yeah.
But it's a nice shot.
Yeah, beautiful light.
Mm. But the eyes are a little out of focus.
Mm. Yeah, it was just a little bit soft. I'm not sure if it's the focus. I cranked the sharpening up trying to fix it.
Okay.
So that's...
But it's still cute.
It could be a low light shot that he's trying to sort of... I don't know if it's noisier.
This is beautiful. Look at that dog's mohawk.
Though all I can see is this little thing.
Yeah.
We kind of
crop
that
out.
Yeah, it is kind of violating the rule of space because he's kind of looking off the frame. Mm. That's not going to help.
Yeah, no, maybe if you do like a portrait orientation instead, you could put it on the left-hand side of the...
Oh, yeah, you're saying, yeah, just crop it like...
Yeah, that solves both that and that.
And it looks like a magazine cover.
Yeah, exactly.
It's beautiful. I like the lighting.
Send it in. I'll send it to the editor.
I don't know why this reminds me of a webcam. Like, he's like, guys... I got a new product review.
What was that YouTube channel you showed me? PewDiePie?
PewDiePie?
Yeah, that's PewDiePie's dog, I think.
Yeah.
How are you Swedish and a YouTube fan and you don't know who PewDiePie is?
Well, I'm Swedish and I can't do a Swedish accent.
PewDiePie?
You know, go figure.
He really can't. He can't do a Swedish accent. I don't
Unless I have an accent right now.
You
then
don't?
I don't know. Because last time I tried, it became like Indian or something.
You did do an Indian accent when you tried to. I don't understand you at all.
I tried. Okay, I'm going to try it for the next sentence. Is going to be Swedish accent. Okay, I'm going to try.
Okay.
It, right. Live in the world.
Okay.
I don't know. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Zooming in here, getting closer, filling the frame with the subject would definitely help. Mm. A lot of distraction in there.
Can I?
And this is.
I was going to say something.
I thought you were going to try to like Swedish, work it in Swedish organically. The composition's a little off here. He's cropped off the frame.
We should have an accent.
Oh, I love this. This is a very nice shot of the dog.
I like that you're cracking yourself up with the Swedish accent.
But there are some crumbs on the pillow. Must go away.
That's not.
And your grammar actually got worse, too.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm horrible at that.
Anyway.
No, but it is. I love the shot.
I do, too. It's very nice.
Yeah, I love the black and white, too.
Oh my gosh.
That's really cute. I can't believe they got to do that.
Yeah, this is good exercise for dogs, especially retrievers who can have some hip problems. It's good to exercise them, to balance them, and strengthen their muscles.
I had no idea that. Were you making that up?
No, I'm not. No,
people
no,
do that?
Definitely not. No, I mean, the forests, that's like the gym for dogs. It's perfect. The everything is perfect.
So. You're cracking Justin
really
up.
Didn't know that.
Yeah, I know. He doesn't believe me.
Justin, business idea for you and me. Doggy gym.
Yeah, that
it's
sounds
just
good.
A forest.
That sounds good.
It's just a forest. Yeah, just keep him running.
Oh, lasagna.
Bring me to your lasagna. Come to me.
Our focus caught the dog's nose.
He's trying to use his mind power to lift the lasagna.
Get to me.
Soon.
Oh.
Dogs playing always looks like dog murder, right? It always looks like an assault.
It's because it is.
It is.
Yeah. That is how they play.
You think they're playing?
No, they're preparing for war. Or some sort of upcoming dog war.
Unsuccessful murder.
I love that. I love the emotion of that previous shot.
Yeah.
Oh, the French.
And just kind of watch the framing here, because we're really close over here. Just a little bit unbalanced.
I love these
little
monsters.
So picky. Come on. Pick. You're picky, so... Oh,
this is such a...
He's been watching the show before. He's been listening.
Yeah, this is
so perfect.
Just like, oh, that's just because it looks like your shots.
Yeah. This could be mine. Look at it.
Look, what kind of narcissist are you?
Oh, that's the highest compliment Eric can
this
take.
This is so good. It's just like mine.
It's just like mine is the best shot ever on this show.
It looks just like what I would do. Okay.
Yeah. But really, it's
what we're talking about. Yeah. All the action in here.
Yeah.
Great expression from the top.
There's something flying on the right that you go if you're going to be really, really picky. But
if you're going to be like Erky.
You don't like that
one. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's some fur or something. I don't know.
That's great, though.
Yeah, that's great. Good. Yeah. I would be interested to hear if he actually saw the show and listened to some advice, because it really does look like those shots.
It really does. Yeah. I would have thought it was yours. Yeah.
Yeah.
Except for that thing on the right.
Yeah, exactly. All of that. I would never miss that. Never, ever.
Look, you are trouble, Swede.
No, I'm not. I'm just Swedish.
I'm nervous about joking with you, because when I joked with Matt Granger, everyone thought I was genuinely being mean to him.
You are a very mean person. Chelsea.
No, I'm a bad...
I want to go, like, on the record now. Live.
Is this thing on?
Is that 1, 2?
Yes. But I don't feel like I ever said I was a nice or good person.
No, you never claimed to be a good person.
No, so why are people holding me to the standard?
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't get it.
Yeah. I didn't send any comments about that.
No.
No.
You understand.
Yeah.
Check those white points a little bit.
Look at his little bow.
And that pink thing.
The hat. The Frenchies are killing me.
That is so cute. What's his name?
Arthur.
Arthur.
Oh, snap.
Oh, that's a great name for a dog.
I like dogs with people names.
Yeah.
He looks like Arthur. Look at his little face.
My next dog, I'm going to call Tony. Actually, I'm going to call him Tony Northrup.
Oh, good. That's a long name to yell when you're chasing
a dog. I can say Tony, or I can say TN, or Rupp, for short. Ruppy. You know, everybody's going to call you Ruppy now.
Ruppy, yeah, great.
Are you going to really get a dog with gray hair? Oh, no, this dog. He looks so nervous. Yeah. He looks like he left the oven on. He's
or a poltergeist.
He's like, I left Carl at school.
A poltergeist.
Like he's seeing your poltergeist.
This is the face I make when I forget I have a doctor's appointment or something.
What's your poltergeist face? Like, if you see a poltergeist?
What's yours?
If you see a poltergeist.
What's yours, Tony? You don't know yours, Tony? I thought everybody knew.
Honestly, The Poltergeist was the scariest movie I saw when I was like 8.
What was your face?
You shouldn't watch that when you're 8. What's wrong with you? This is very pink.
No, it wasn't to begin with.
You did that.
Tony ruined it.
Yeah, I tried to use the auto white balance and it didn't work at all.
It's still dark.
There's like no getting the color right.
I know, that's why you go black and white.
1/8 of a second. That's really, really slow.
That's true. It actually is pretty sharp for 1/8.
This was a really dark, low light situation.
And still
1.7
at ISO 1600.
This is like pitch black.
Yeah. Why are you stalking this poor dog? Does he even know you're there?
He doesn't. Look at his face. He's
no, he has no idea. This is really creepy.
Yeah.
It's like night vision.
It's like Buffalo Bill.
You see the ears are up. He's hearing him. It's like, who's there?
There's someone in the dark. It's a poltergeist.
Oh no, this dog's so sweet.
Oh, he's doing workout too. Is that like a
barbell?
Yeah.
How can he use that? He doesn't have a thumb.
Oh no, they do. They do. That's nice.
Yeah.
Is it? I will say, some sort of hard light really helps with dark dogs.
Yeah.
Because otherwise their whole fur can disappear. But the texture in the fur is perfect on this shot.
Yeah.
And I'm glad to see that he's into fitness.
Oh my god. He's into fitness.
This is really cute. It reminds me of an Indian running dog or running duck. Don't you think, with that really long neck?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Indian running duck.
640 F2 ISO 100. Huh. Perfect.
It's so nice. I love the nice, simple, blurred out background.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like you said before, they probably called him or did something to get his attention.
I bet he's like, cookie. He's like, what?
Yeah. Cookie?
Me.
Cookie? Beer? Beer?
That's how I get you to look nice in pictures.
Yeah. Like, licorice. Make that sound like when you open a beer can, like,
psh. I ruffle the little licorice bag.
Ah, yeah.
Because you love your candy.
Yeah.
So check the negative space below the dog and above the dog, and you can see it's a little more below the feet than it is above the ears. So we're just going to crop it down a little bit, balance it a little bit better. Otherwise, terribly cute.
What do you think? I'm going to give it a pick, wife?
But I'm also going to read
it. Every day, every time I come out in the morning, he's like, oh, your dress isn't like, cropped right.
That's like this one molecule too low.
Look at this.
What can we do for this?
It's piebald.
Crop it.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah, there's just a little bit of distractions in here.
Who's picky now?
Well, that was obvious.
No.
It was obvious.
Please.
See?
That does help.
Much better.
We could have also used a lower ISO and gotten rid of some of that noise. Could have shot it. You know, 1/60th would have been fine. And dog's not moving especially fast.
Oh, dog show.
I think that's
Is that my camera?
That's your D500.
You want to go get it?
You have to sign for it? Or
yeah, you have to sign for it.
But it's in your...
Oh, they don't care about that. But
okay, I'm gonna sign for it. No. Let me out.
Go. Be free.
Oh my God.
Can I go under?
Oh. Speaking of dogs,
you're actually so tangled up right now.
I am.
I will just go sign.
Here, I'll help you.
All right.
You guys take the show.
Okay, this is live, people. Okay, this is what happens. You have to be on this side.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's a dog.
Is it wet? Oh, it's taking a bath. Yeah. I like it. It looks like a little monkey. Can you imagine if I did the show, everyone would
I think this show is like completely lost now.
Yeah, but you gave us all of this alcohol.
We haven't drunk any alcohol. It's
mine evaporated.
Oh, crap. Now it did that thing again.
You need bigger ears.
Yeah.
I like the colors, the nice warm colors. I think it's a great composition, don't you, Erky? Nice and simple.
Yeah, maybe should. Okay, I'm not going to be Tony now and Picky Pickerson.
No, yeah, you're Picky Pickerson.
Because it might be better.
What happened here?
Is it? Did it arrive?
Oh, yes. Your wife is signing for it.
My D500?
Yeah.
Am I 200, 500, like big, wonderful lens?
Well, I didn't unpack everything.
It's in the same house as me.
Yeah, but we're taking the new...
The people who are watching this know exactly what I'm feeling right now. Like,
but you actually have a D500 in the same lens that you've been shooting with all week.
I know, but that was mine. Yes, of course. What's wrong with you?
Yeah, and you haven't kind of broken them.
Yeah, not yet.
We're taking the new one.
I broke his D500.
I know. I was there.
Yeah.
Crying.
Yeah, you did. No, I'm sorry. I cried too a little. Okay.
Look at this little pumpkin.
This is
a little bit.
Why is it so dark?
Yeah, it's washed out. We got whites and blacks.
Maybe it was a rainy day or dark day. Because it's 1:2000 ISO 800, but it shouldn't be that. Buddy having fun. He's having fun.
All right, just a little bit of contrast I added and warmed it up a tiny bit, and then. He's just frozen like that.
Yeah, no, but it's good, actually.
He's cute.
But it's just something wrong with the lighting here.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice lighting.
Yeah.
That's cute.
That's perfect.
No complaints. You did it.
No, you got it. Good start. Give him some stars or something.
I'll give him 5 stars.
We haven't seen one golden retriever today. What's wrong with you people? You don't know who I am?
There's so much character to it.
I don't like... This is like that fringing you get. Purpley.
Yeah.
You have to be careful when you build this. You have to look at whatever's on the horizon, leaves, grass, and make sure you're not getting that distortion. And if you are, you can always use this graduated filter and blend it in.
Mm-hmm.
That's a hot tip for you. But other than that, I like the leading line. I like the guy with the dog and the
There's cane. A storytelling here. Yes. That's wonderful. The post got to go on the left, that little...
Oh, God. Picky Pickerson.
It's not picky.
You're right. It throws off the balance a little bit.
Yeah. And it's so easy to get rid of. Just crop it so
people I like can it. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, hello.
That is cute. I'm going to just bring up the shadows a tiny bit to see if we can get a bit more detail on his face.
Mm.
Exposed for him.
It was probably exposed like matrix on Nikon. What do you call that on Canon when it exposes?
Evaluative metering.
Right. Because you got the bright window and the curtain, and that's why it's underexposing the
what
dog.
What do you think? So, just a little more in the face of the dog.
Mm,
Yeah, yeah, that's much better.
Maybe drop the blacks a little bit.
Yeah.
Contrast in there.
But. Yeah. Yeah, and if you want a little more contrast, you can. Mm. I put up the contrast, but you can also drop the blacks.
Yeah.
But I love the curtain and the light.
Yeah, but a shot like that either bump up the exposure compensation, maybe a few stops, or spot metering.
Right. He's saying that because it's backlit. So if you use exposure compensation, you'll be exposing for the dog instead of the majority of the picture.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's a good shot.
Oh.
This is fantastic.
Are you a puppy?
It is. Is it in a studio? Is that soft lights or soft boxes?
I did feel like maybe the blacks were a little too dark.
Yeah, maybe.
I don't know. I'm having a hard time recovering this at this point, but
yeah, you wouldn't be able to recover from a JPEG.
But it's cute. It's
Griffin. Cool name too. Yeah, great.
Oh.
Yep.
Nobody would play with him.
Just raise the shadow. Maybe the overall exposure is a little bit to the left. Looking up there. Yep, yep. And maybe some it's better. Right?
That's nice.
Watch the histogram, people.
Yeah, but
we don't do that anymore?
No, we say that all the time.
Oh, you do? I thought maybe you stopped doing that.
No, people say we say the same thing every show. But like, is that our fault?
It was an update to the book and I missed it again.
Yeah, we're like, ignore the histogram.
We're not doing the histogram thing anymore.
That is so
2015.
Oh.
Yeah.
Nanook.
Yeah.
I feel like the same critique would apply. Like, you'd want to raise those white points a little bit.
Mm.
But, I mean, I know we've done this for every picture.
Yeah. People get mad.
It's a little bit centered.
Yeah. Like, it'd be nice to have some space to the left to look into.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
The rule of space.
Give it some space. Rule of space.
You know where I learned about that? Too? Chapter 1, Stunning Digital Photography.
Oh, I haven't gotten that far.
Did you? We just read the introduction?
Not just the intro.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I only read the contributor where my name is.
Oh, twice. Stop. You read it twice.
No, my name is on there twice.
Oh, that's a typo. We meant zero times.
No, it's not
times.
A typo. I'm twice as valuable.
No, we meant it.
You meant it.
We did not. This is the you face I make it, right? At you, Eric.
Yeah, it's a little suspicious. Like, really? You rented a car from the gas station?
Really?
Really?
Really.
I like
you
it.
You told the guy... Just give me alcohols. Just,
you have to crop from the top a little bit, just a little bit. It seems off.
Yeah, get those eyes at the upper third.
Yeah, that's what it is. The rule of thirds,
Yeah.
Don't be afraid to cut his hair. I do it all the time. Look at me.
Yeah. We're full Peter Hurley.
I cut my hair like every other day, and I have no problem with it.
That explains that.
Yeah. No, that's
nice
that's
dog.
Much better. Yeah.
I brought down the highlights just a bit to show some texture in the fur, too.
Yeah.
An adorable little dog.
But the background is in focus.
So see, the lighting is kind of like he's half
we
in
went,
bright light. And shadow.
Because it's a puppy.
It's cute.
It's a puppy. It's not because it's not because of the photograph.
That was really cruel.
It was, but I am a Viking after all. I can't just not be a Viking.
Well, but seriously, is the most important thing.
It is.
So
it
a
is.
Bad picture of a really cute puppy is going to win. It's a great picture of a dog like Sandy, a really ugly dog.
What?
Oh, well, Sandy's very
What
ugly.
Did Sandy do to you?
Well, she's a monster.
No, but my point is, she still got this, or whoever took this photo got the, like that. And that's still valuable. But there's a lot we can do better with this shot.
So you want...
The dog gets credit for that.
You want the dog...
The dog gets credit for the...
Yes.
Right?
But they want... So photographer...
Right.
Check the edges of the frame. The paws got cut off there a little bit. It's a little close to the top of the head. So either want to zoom in on the head or zoom back a little bit, but you don't want to crop just into the paw.
But they did some things right. They got great eye contact, which was missing in a lot of the pictures.
That's good. That's on the plus side.
A good expression.
Yeah.
And now they just need to put the dog in better light and give it distance from the background so that the background isn't so prominent.
And a lower angle. This is a grown-up angle. Oh, actually, I saw one in the Facebook group.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember who did that, but that was cool. It had taken the shot like straight up, straight from you couldn't even almost see the body of the dog.
Mm-hmm.
It was just a head.
Yeah. But it makes it look small.
It was so cool. I never thought about doing that. That was I'm going to try that sometime.
So, you know, actually, that's some stunning digital photography. So now I know you actually didn't read our book.
Yeah, no, I didn't read it. I'm not lying.
You can't speak English though, so.
No, you have to release the Swedish one because I can't read. I can speak English, but I can't read it.
You have to get a hotel tonight. I'm sorry, we're booked here.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I knew it.
Oh my gosh, that is the cutest little gremlin.
But black and white, what do we need to do?
Lots of contrast. Yeah.
You have to repeat this every show, right?
Yes, every show.
Why is that? People are not listening.
Oh, no, people don't listen to us.
But it's a great shot. I love this. Look at that.
Well, we're at quarter after, so maybe we should toss it back to Siobhan.
Siobhan.
The time goes so fast.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Siobhan, how are you living?
I'm living.
You're living.
A bunch of people in the comments want Erky to unbox his camera live, which I think would be the most boring.
I'll go fetch your camera.
Yeah, I can't move because I'm...
You field questions.
I'm a prisoner here. They locked me up here.
I have questions for you, though, Erky.
Okay.
How did you decide that dog photography was your thing?
That's a good question. I didn't, really. I sort of just fell into it because I got... Well, first I got the camera. Then I was thinking I need a dog to go with me when I go out with my camera. Because I was feeling alone.
Yeah.
So I got a golden retriever puppy, and when I got the puppy, I wanted to take some basic classes. Okay. and through that, I started meeting dog people, and I brought my camera and I started taking pictures for them for free, just to get experience.
So dog people and like werewolves.
How do you mean?
Don't mess with the Swede.
Don't mess with the Swede with a knife.
All right. Open
no,
it.
But seriously. So then after that, it was mainly just networking and getting my picture shown to more and more dog people. And now it's just spread all over. I've been to Denmark and all across different parts of Sweden. And now I'm even in the US taking dog pictures. What are you doing?
Judging you.
What do you mean?
With this knife, you mean?
No. Okay.
Really, what I'm doing is I'm just imagining dog people in my head.
Yeah. So did that even answer the question? Because I'm all, like, hyped up right now.
All right.
I have no idea what
right
I'm talking
now.
About. Yeah, more than usual.
Look at your Swedish. You got to show off the Swedish. There you go.
Oh, yeah. The Viking.
Show off those guns, sir.
Oh, my God. I can't believe it.
The Nikon D500.
Look at this, people. You guys know the feeling, right?
Wow.
Oh, yeah. You got to get a memory card reader because they take XQD cards. Oh.
XQD. They always come up with these stupid things to make you buy more stuff. No, it's actually very good, right?
I'm shaking.
Faster.
It is good.
What is better with this?
It's faster. That's all. It's just faster.
And faster is better, right?
If you smell this camera, I'm kicking your ass back to Sweden.
Okay, tell I'm not going to smell it.
He just tastes it.
I'm not gonna smell it.
Erky's taste test.
I'm gonna taste it. Okay, live on
just
YouTube.
Lick it. What does it taste like?
Okay.
Snozzberries.
Do you have my camera?
Yeah, you're on. Tony's body is just in front of you.
So I'm gonna lick it. I'm not gonna smell it. Okay, maybe just a little.
That voids like the warranty. All right.
Oh, baby, my little baby. Oh, look at it. Can you see that? Oh.
Oh, Erky, you have to peel off the protective cover from the LCD.
Look at this, Tony. I know you love this.
Oh.
Can you see that?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to do it close to the mic.
There you go.
Okay, shut up.
Oh, man.
Oh, look at it. It's so shiny.
He's so giddy.
I keep dropping this thing still.
Erky, look at your lens.
And here's your 200 to 500.
It's so big, Tony.
That's what she said. Yeah. It's too easy.
It's
big. It's beneath me, but I have to, right?
Is that it?
Yes.
I'm so disappointed.
My Canon DO version.
Oh, look at this thing. Oh. I can't believe my wife actually allowed me to buy this.
Allowed you? She encouraged it.
She encouraged it. Yeah, I was like, really? It's a lot of money. And...
But your wife is wonderful on so many levels.
Oh, plus, you didn't tell her about the U.S. to Swedish krona conversion.
Yeah.
You said it was $1,300.
Yeah, it's $1,300 Swedish. Look at it. Can I smell this?
All right. Smell it.
Wait, that
this feels like an intimate moment. Should I be here still?
Yeah.
Do you need your own private space?
Is this allowed on YouTube?
No. We're going to have to mark this episode mature.
Okay, there's no battery. I can't take a picture now, right? Oh, it's stuck.
Are you okay?
No, I'm not. I'm all shaky.
It is beautiful. This setup just
and this one I just throw away, right? Because I don't need this.
You want here? Right. Go to me.
I've noticed you've been training your kids to use lens caps, yeah, and I'm kind of ashamed.
Okay, where's my camera?
There, sir.
Okay, here you go, people. Can you do the shutter sound?
Yeah.
All right, ready?
Okay, all right. The machine gun sound.
It.
Okay.
Ready? Set. Go. Okay. Whoa.
So
dang.
Cue. Imagine what I'm gonna do with this baby.
I don't want to know after you licked it, smelled it, caressed it.
What, you don't do that? Well, you're married. I'm also married. How the
Swedish swinger.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, that was great.
It's getting hot in here.
It is.
Well, you have any last questions or comments before we?
I just want to take a look at this picture.
For a delicious burger. Yeah. Okay, we got another. This is hilarious.
What the heck? This looks like a buddy cop movie, but it's dogs. He's small and spunky. He's a giant monster. It's adorable.
He doesn't even know he's there. Look, he's looking at some person. Actually, it's hard. It's hard to get. You can't get two dogs.
What do you think that big dog is saying?
What is he saying?
Backen.
He's saying beer.
He's so
dogs
cute.
Love beer. You don't know that, right?
Yes, I know that.
Yeah, you know that.
That looks just like your dog.
5 stars and a pick.
This dog, I want to know from whoever sent this in. Is this an American dog? Because
does
I know
to be?
No, because I noticed in your dog Shiro, he has that little upturned nose, and I've never seen an American Golden Retriever with that before. And I was wondering.
I'm not sure if it's necessarily American.
I'm wondering if dogs look different in different places.
There are different types of Golden Retrievers.
Oh, are there?
So I would guess, and maybe the comments will prove me wrong, but I think this is from Europe because it looks more like a European type of
That's
Golden
what I
Retriever.
Thought, a European.
It does. The American breed is slightly different.
It looks more red, and their nose is straight.
Yeah, and this is white.
And longer. Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's very cute.
I'm betting European.
They have mixed light sources here. You can see there's blue on the top of the nose and very yellow here, so I might just put it in black and white just to balance the light. So,
what?
Are you okay?
He's rather distracted.
If you're excited about that, you're gonna love the burger tonight.
We're gonna have the best burger in the world.
We never said in the world.
You did. You implied it.
Siobhan, can we get one more question before we head out?
One more question. Dogs.
Sure. Sweet.
We lost you.
What? Justin? Justin muted me.
No, you're on.
Okay.
We can hear you.
I can't.
Okay, what's a good last question for you? Do you have any tricks on shooting untrained dogs that are hard to get to pose, Erky?
Good question.
Very good question. If you don't have a trained dog, I would use two people. If we're talking about the running... and action shots. You need one person to hold the dog and another person to attract the dog. But if the dog is not trained, you need to find what attracts a dog. And that's usually candy or treats.
A treat.
And just show the dog that, look what I have. You know, get him going. And one person holding him back to the point where he's trying to break free.
Yes.
Right? He just wants that candy. And then you just run behind the photographer and then release the dog. And it's going to run like a crazy person.
Yes.
Straight for the treat, which is just behind the camera.
That's a great tip.
Yeah. And that goes with dogs in any situation. You need to get them motivated to do what you want. Right? Trained or not.
We struggled with Sandy a bit.
We did, but that was, I didn't struggle with Sandy so much as with you.
Like, well, I
you know
actually,
the whole thing, get out of the frame.
I'm not trained, though.
You're not, and so. Yeah, I don't know.
I mean,
okay, that's
and
a
also
different show.
Nobody offered me candy. I'd like to point that out.
Yeah,
you have to figure out how to motivate Chelsea.
Yeah,
candy.
Yeah, candy. Right? Waffles.
Yeah, right? That's the way to go.
Waffles.
Yeah, waffles.
She loves waffles.
You love waffles.
Pancake.
Really? Swedish?
No.
Denial.
Okay, Erki, thank you so much for joining us and for you gave such valuable advice.
I hope
you're
I did
you're
something.
A delight.
Really?
Well, I don't know. I have to say that.
Squarespace are paying you to say that.
They actually asked me to say that. Siobhan, thank you so much for reading the comments and for having the best hair every week. And Justin,
you always bring your
thank
hair
you and happy birthday, Justin.
Happy birthday, Justin.
Oh, you didn't open your thing.
No, no, no. I know Siobhan just said, oh you got to open your stuff. But I wanted to say thank you so much from awesome Kyle Wolf.
Aww.
I'm sorry about this beer, but yes, this is beautiful. It's like nice metal print. That was really cool.
Is it a metal print?
Yes, yes.
Oh, it's so cool.
Thank you so much, Kyle.
Justin,
that's awesome.
Put the party hat on.
And then
God
I got
sakes,
this party
man.
Hat.
That's the whole point of a hat.
Justin.
And I got these
Justin
killer
behind his head. I don't think he's ever had a party.
Killer brews. Yeah, good times. Yeah.
What is that? The 90 minute or?
This is. Yes, the 90 minute. Very nice.
Ooh,
very
be
nice.
Careful with that. That's yes. Dangerous.
I got you all different kinds, Justin.
Oh, you did. I'm sorry.
Each one is different. You don't have to bring.
Oh,
I'm just telling you for
your... Oh, that's awesome. Thank you. I love Dogfish Head. Good beer. Good beer. Yeah.
I wish he could be my brother.
I like Justin much more than I like you.
Oh, everybody does.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, you
Justin
knew that,
likeable.
Right?
Yeah, I knew that.
He's very likable.
Truly, he's likable. Yeah. All right. Nice. So thank you, Squarespace. Once again, if you'd like to try out a Squarespace portfolio, you can go to squarespace.com. You can get 14 days free, no credit card needed. If you decide to sign up, go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code portfolio. That will get you 10% off. It will also tell Squarespace we're doing a good job and they may continue to keep the show going, hopefully. Fingers crossed. Thank you so much for watching and thank all of everyone here. Thanks so much, guys. Goodbye.
Bye. See you next week. Thursdays at 5 New York City time. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Teagar.
Teag.
That is all.
Okay, we did it.
I think
it.
I just messed up that show.
You did. You'll never be on the show.